We are here at the String Lake Trailhead, about to set out on a 3-day backpacking trip. It's August 3rd, 2020, about 10 a.m. and about 60 degrees. Got a pretty good look at Tiwanat on the left and Mount Owen on the right with the snow. This is Cascade Canyon. A lot of color in this field here. One last view of Grand Teton before it hides behind Mount Owen. Got Tiwanat. Tiwanat's right there. That's the Grand Teton. There's Mount Owen. got a peanut butter and jelly burrito for lunch. A little marinated. What are we eating here?
An apple. Gala apple.
Don't even think about getting at my M&Ms.
Interesting. Those are mine.
Alright, now that we're a few miles up trail, we'll explain what our plan for the day is. We started out at this String Lake parking loop here, and we hiked along the east side of String Lake about a mile, and then we hiked along this stream here connecting String Lake and Ginny Lake, and this really beautiful trail on the north side of Ginny Lake, and then we turned west up canyon at the horse trail. You can also go up to the Inspiration Point Trail, but we took the horse trail instead. And now we're up in Cascade Canyon, probably right around here. And our plan for the day is to go on this south fork of Cascade Canyon. There's camping in here and there's camping in this north fork too, but that was all booked up for this whole week. We were actually originally planning on going up Paintbrush Canyon and then down through this way, but since there's no camping in here, we modified our plans a bit. So now we're going on the South Fork. We're gonna go over Hurricane Pass on the Teton Crest Trail. And this is actually outside of the park, but this is called Alaska Basin, and all this pink area is open to camping. So we'll camp somewhere in here tonight. So that's where we're heading for the day. We're going up this canyon right here. That's the South Fork Cascade Canyon. I believe the North Fork is up this way by Lake Solitude. But we're gonna head south behind the Tetons. Grand Teton. Sam's filling up some water.
these guys are doing today? They came from the Alaska Basin.
Here's a look at the fork of Cascade Canyon. Here's Cascade Canyon. There's the North Fork. And here's the South Fork that we've been coming up. Getting some elevation now. There's a nice view of Grand Teton. The tallest one in the background and the west summit of the Grand Teton right in front of it. there's our pass. Right there, Hurricane Pass. We'll get over there and see Alaska Basin where we're gonna camp. There's Mount Moran, looking to the north. Here we are on Hurricane Pass. Down there is the Alaska Basin and Idaho.
And camp.
And camp. There's the Grand Teton. See the lower saddle right here. The Exum Ridge up here. That's the west summit of the Grand Teton right there. I can find my finger. It's also called the enclosure because there's these really cool like stone slabs arranged in a circle on the summit of the enclosure. It's thought that those were created by Native Americans, so it's pretty cool. Good look at Alaska Basin. You fellas live in that hole there? Thank you. camping somewhere down in there tonight. Maybe by that lake. Up there, you think? What are we cooking here?
Got some good soup cooking. Pasta.
Look at that sizzle. That's where we came from. Put that away.
Be good.
Mm-mm. morning, day two. Spent the night here at Sunset Lake. Yeah, it was a good day yesterday, and today we're looking at following the Teton Crest Trail. We're gonna head south and then go up on the Death Canyon Shelf, and then we'll turn east up Death Canyon and find somewhere to camp for tonight. So it should be a good day. Might be a little less water sources today, so we may have to plan for that and fill up an extra bottle, but it should be really good. Anything to add from last night?
Yesterday was just a great day. You know, we got views of the Grand and the three Tetons, and it was hard, but it was really, really worth it. That South Fork of Cascade Canyon was amazing.
Cool.
So just to look at the map here for what our plan is for today. We camped here at Sunset Lake. It was really beautiful. We're gonna head south, keep going south at the fork, and then we're gonna start heading up on this Death Canyon Shelf following the Teton Crest Trail. Go all along the shelf, and we're gonna turn east at Fox Creek Pass here and start heading down Death Canyon. And that's where we're going to camp tonight, maybe halfway down the canyon, but all of this area here is okay for camping, so we'll find a spot there tonight. Here's a good look at Buck Mountain, big one on the left, and then Static Peak right in the middle. Grand Teton starting to show itself now. Now we're on the south side of it. So we came from the opposite side. So this is kind of cool. The stream comes along, goes down into that hole, to who knows where. It's pretty interesting.
It's our first good look down Death Canyon. Be sleeping down there tonight.
That's where we're going, up on that hill.
It's a good look at the Teton Range from the south. That's the Grand, then Middle and South, I believe, are kind of in line there.
That's our trail down there. Making the descent into Death Canyon now. Just past Fox Creek Pass. It's really like swimming in Wildflowers.
Well, that shelf up there is where we came from this morning. Went all along the top. And then we turned down into Death Canyon, which is where we are now. I think those trees way up there on the ridgeline, like right there, I think that's where we ate lunch today. For tonight's meal, cheddar broccoli. So we had to move our tent because we accidentally set up camp in the group camping site, so now we moved it over here, but right next to this sweet bear box to keep all our stuff.
We even got some tea.
Tea. Some flatland climbing tea. Well, we had a pretty crazy night last night. It all started with Sam getting up and walked over there by that tree. Saw a grizzly bear. Well, we think it was a grizzly bear because it was big. Walking right over there, kind of by that sign. I stopped and looked at him. So he got back in the tent and we made some noise to let it know that we were there. Our tent was right here. And then the noises continued into the night and our packs, which were leaning against this tree here, there was some kind of critter that was really going after them, and find out this morning that they really tore apart Sam's pack and ripped off the chest strap there and really went after it for some reason, and not mine, but yeah, it was a pretty crazy night. We didn't get very much sleep.
There wasn't any food in the packs or anything, so.
Yeah, all the food is down there. So we don't know why it was chewing on it, but it was chewing on it. Sam's fixing up his pack strap from the damage that that mystery animal did. So here's our plan for the last day. We're camped about right here. We're just gonna follow Death Canyon all the way down to the north side of Phelps Lake, and then follow this trail around the edge of Phelps Lake along the southwest side, and then kind of find our way through the woods here. Eventually we'll come out at this Rockefeller Preserve Center that's right there, and that's where we'll finish. There's a pair of moose blocking our trail right up there. Two cows. So I guess we're just gonna wait them out. Here's a look at Phelps Lake. That's where we're ending our trip, down on the south side. Getting very near the end. There it is. Trail's end.